Snickers, Mom?
Hi, my name is Glenda. Please stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance. Put your right hand over your heart, ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, and liberty and justice for all. Hoy en español. Yo prometo lealtad a la bandera de los Estados Unidos y de América para una república y nación que representa bajo Dios y libertad y justicia para todos. Please remain standing up for a national anthem performed by Helen.
We watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets regular, the bombs bursting in, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
To Helen Bernstein High School graduation ceremony. We're glad that you can join us on this special occasion to celebrate awesome to introduce you of the graduated class of 2023. to welcome you and the many languages spoken here in Helen Bernstein.
Clase de graduados del 2023, damos la bienvenida a padres, familiares y amigos a la ceremonia de graduación de la secundaria Helen Bernstein. Nos alegra que hayas podido unirte a nosotros en esta ocasión especial para celebrar un giro en la vida de nuestros graduados.
Sa ngalan na magtatapos ng senior class ng 2023, malugod namin sinasalubong ang mga magulang, kamag-anak at kaibigan sa seremonya ng magtatapos sa Helen Bernstein High School. Natutuwa kaming makasama ka sa espesyal na okasyong ito upang ipagdiwang ang isang milestone sa buhay ng aming mga nagtapos. Salamat.
To present the director of our Helen Bernstein High School, Mr. Alejandro Ramirez.
I'm going to give a round of applause to Glenda, who did such an awesome job over here. Dragons. Wow. Here we are. You know, I spent the last few weeks thinking about this speech. I wanted this speech to be a little different because, you know, obviously, anyone who has been on this journey with you the last 4 years knows that life has been a little different. So the first thing I told myself was, you know what? Get rid of that usual, good evening, teachers, staff, parents, you know, blah, blah, blah. But I feel like I'm being rude, so you know what? Let me start over. Good evening, teachers, staff, parents, and of course, the graduating class of 2023. I'm so excited to be up here today to recognize and honor this year's class. Seniors, it has been an arduous 4 years. Life has thrown many challenges your way. If we really stop to talk about why life has been different for you these 4 years, I don't think we'll finish by tonight. So instead of talking about the roadblocks that life has thrown at you, let's talk about your highlights and accomplishments. Let's talk about our league champion football team that went 9-2 this year. Including a wipeout of Hollywood High School. That's right. Was it 52-9? Something like that. Let's talk about the success our high school cheerleading team had with getting fourth place in the final competition. Let's talk about our CIF Division III champion cross country girls that went to state for the first time. Let's talk about our CIF Division III softball championship team that also went to state for the first time. Softball girls, raise that pinky up. That's right. Let's talk about winning second place on that build competition design for the first time that we competed. We're already up there. Let's talk about the great book our students put together with Paramount Studios. Let's talk about our international students being accepted into four-year universities. including this year's salutatorian who got a full ride to USC. Jason, I'm still mad at you for not taking NMU, but it's okay. Let's talk about the year of the Ashleys. You know, now that I think about it, talking about your accomplishments will probably keep us here longer than talking about your challenges. So let's rewind again. Let's make this a personal reflection. Dragons, take a moment right now to think about your own accomplishments these last few years. Many of you passed that one class you never thought you were going to pass. I'm not going to say any teachers' names, but you know you exhaled when you saw that final grade come in. Take a moment to think about that new club that you started at Bernstein, which many of you did. Take a moment about that time that you truly felt that dragon pride after passing that test that you swore you were never going to be able to pass. Dragons, let's get even more personal. Think about your own personal success at home. Take a moment to think about the time you finally realized you became the role model for your little brother or sister. Take a moment to think about the time you finally realized you were becoming an adult. Getting your acceptance letters, or being accepted into the military, or being told that yes, you got that job. Take a moment to think about the time you finally agreed with your parents and realized, hey, maybe they were right. So what now? Are we done? Right, not even close. These accomplishments, both personal and professional, are the first steps to what promises to be a bright future. Dragons, you have tasted the nectar of life. You've savored that wonderful taste that life can truly offer, but that was only a sample. Life has numerous adventures awaiting your path, along with countless success. Yet, just like these last 4 years have shown you, it's not going to be easy. There are going to be many challenges in your way. There will be many obstacles that will get in your path. You are going to come across a time when you think you cannot succeed. But if these last 4 years have shown you anything, if that dragon fire inside of you has proven who you really are, then you know that there is nothing or no one that will be able to stop you. You will determine how far you go in life. You will be the one who decides how high up that ladder you climb. And if these last 4 years have also shown you anything, when you do stumble and fall, you know that you're going to have either your own personal family or your dragon family here to pick you right back up and push you to keep going forward. Congrats, class of 2023. Now, it is my honor to introduce our senior class president, Ms. Carla, will not cry, Flores.
Teachers, staff, friends, and most importantly, graduates! How's everyone feeling tonight? My name is Carla Flores, your ASB president. I apologize, like he mentioned, I cry a lot. So if I shed some tears, I'm really sorry. Graduates, I want to start off by saying that our 12 years in school are finally over, and that is something we should all be proud of. I know that everyone has faced ups and downs throughout this long journey, but you not giving up is incredibly amazing.
It's okay, Carla.
look how far you all have gotten. Being here, sitting down in your cap and gown that we spent last night stressing about, is a milestone that is not given to you for free, and you have worked insanely hard for it. As for whatever you're doing after we receive this diploma, whether it's continue going to school to pursue a career, taking time off to work on yourself, or work to gain that money, I'm super proud of you all, and I think all of you should be as well. I strongly believe that you all will be able to surpass any challenges that face you guys in the future. To the people I talked to, that I said, hi, how are you? To the ones I've had long conversations with, or ones I saw around campus or in the halls, I hope that you all have created memorable memories here that you will cherish forever, or even learn valuable lessons that have taught you to be a stronger, responsible, or in general, have made you grow to be a bigger person in any manner. Never forget that even though school can be super challenging at times, this has been a home for the past 4 years, or however long you all have been here. And for that, I want to take the time to thank teachers and staff here that have made everyone here feel safe, welcomed, and appreciated here at school. I want to take a moment to highlight a special three, Miss Martinez, Miss Santos, that's all the way in the back from the control room, and Mr. Washington. To Mr. Washington, you have seen me grow from the very beginning and have taught me so much. You have always reassured me and have always believed that I'm capable of anything I set myself up to. And for that, I'm very grateful. I will miss you so much, Mr., but I know that that you're an amazing teacher, and any kid is lucky to have a teacher like you. Now, Ms. Santos, listen up closely. Or as how me and my friends call her, Miss Sandy Toes. You have been more than just a teacher for me and my friends. You have been a person I can go to whenever I need someone to talk to or just have a laugh with. You are truly someone I can trust without being judged. Your class is my safe space here at school, but it's not because of the class or subject you teach. It's because of the energy you give that I feel safe. It's hard to know that there's going to be no more. Guys, let's go to Ms. Santos, and you being there, happy to see us. The hardest thing for me is that I know that I won't be able to go to you as often as I usually do. But I know having you is not the enemy talking to you. We have built a connection that is super strong and is more than just an in-school thing. I have left the teacher, but have gained a person that is extremely valuable in my life, and for that, I love you so much. Okay, to Miss Martinez, or as I have called you before, Mom. You have really been the definition of being a second mom to me. I miss your warm, tight hugs that you give me whenever I see you, or your, hi, Chiquita, how are you? You have shown me so much love and have pushed me to be here, to be the best version of myself. There have been times where I haven't believed in myself or thought, no, someone can do it better, and there you were saying, no, Chiquita, you can do it. Those times I've complained about my head hurting, my stomach hurting, or just feeling down, you have always been there to make me feel better. I appreciate all the hard work you pour into the school. Above all of this, you have always made room to make me feel like I have someone to talk to, even when there were so many things on your plate. I'll forever appreciate you and everything you have done for me from the bottom of my heart, Miss. I love you so much, and I'll miss you. Now, to my special group of friends and my special someone, you guys know who you are. Spending my last 4 years with you, or even though I haven't met all of you my full 4 years, there has been nothing but laughter. There has never been a dull time with you guys. You guys are the reason why I enjoy coming to school. We have created so many memories that I'll never forget. Seeing you guys today, sitting in your cap and gown, makes me so proud of you guys. You guys are not my best friends, you guys are my family. Thank you guys for being so amazing and just being you. I love you guys so much.
Love you too!
And last, but not most importantly, my guest of honor tonight, mi familia. Este diploma que estoy a punto de recibir no es solo un logro mío, pero un logro para ustedes también. Especialmente quiero agradecerle a mi mamá y a mi papá por ser mis dos grandes soportes en mis momentos más difíciles. Gracias, papá, por amarme incondicionalmente. Eres un gran ejemplo para mí. Te amo. Para mi mamá, gracias por despertarte cada mañana por los últimos 12 años, aunque a veces sean no las más mejores mañanas, pero ahí vamos. Por traerme a la escuela para darme una buena educación. Siempre me has apoyado en las metas que quiero cumplir y en las que ya he cumplido. Te amo, mami. And also my cousins are here. Shout out to you guys. And there's also a second family over there. I don't know where you guys are sitting. Debbie, Irma, Tony, Emmy, all of you guys. I love you guys so much, and thank you for supporting me in everything I do. Thank you, everyone, for coming. I mean, for listening. Well, and coming here, of course. And once again, class of 2023, we did it. Now, I would like to introduce Miss Diana Martinez Favela, our assistant principal.
Hello, graduates. Okay, at this time, I would like to recognize those diligent students who have strived to achieve academic success. The first group of students I will name have earned a cumulative GPA of 3.6 and above as a high school student and will have a gold seal affixed to their high school diploma, as well as being distinguished with a gold honor cord. Honored students with gold cords, please stand. Congratulations. Please be seated. I am very honored to present to you the valedictorian for the graduating class of 2023. Ashley Rivera Abarca is a graduating senior with the highest GPA of 4.26. She will attend the University of California, Los Angeles in the fall. Tonight, Ashley will present the valedictory address.
Before I begin, I just want to say I'm really sick, and I apologize for the coughing. And Carla, you did an amazing job. You almost made me cry like 5 times. Okay, good evening. I would like to begin by welcoming friends and families and saying congratulations to my fellow graduates. We made it. Just being here is a huge accomplishment. This is the beginning of the rest of our lives. We had a rough 4 years, and time went by too fast. And our time was cut short during our freshman year. When we came back, I still felt like a lost freshman. The only difference being that I could actually find Ms. Santos' room this time. But by the end of our junior year, I think most of us started to feel the pressure of being upperclassmen. But we still felt like sophomores. We were still lost. And I'm still in denial that our time at Bernstein is now over. But what really made me feel like an upperclassman or a senior
was when we started College Apps. I remember freshman year, my friend Kirsten was like a walking encyclopedia on all the UC schools, and I was just left standing there dumbfounded. I was totally lost, as I'm sure many of you were. But I think we figured it out. And I think we did a pretty good job. You did, yeah? All this to say, we had a really interesting high school experience. Nothing a high school movie could have ever predicted. But we survived it, and today is the day we get to celebrate. I am immensely proud of every single one of you, and I know that we as a class have the potential to accomplish so much. We did it! It's just hard, okay? It's really hard looking out into the crowd, okay? Now, when they told me I had to write a speech for graduation, I started panicking. Yeah, like that? Like that? I'm really bad at public speaking. I speak too fast, and I get really nervous, but I'm still up here, and that proves we're capable of everything. I had no idea what to say to you guys. I had no life advice, no poetic metaphors, and I believed I had nothing to say. But I was lucky enough to have Dr. Lippman to guide me and to help me brainstorm. She helped me organize my thoughts and find my voice. So here are my three pieces of advice as valedictorian. Because apparently I have to give you advice, I don't know why. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing either. Okay. First, surround yourself with people who support and believe in you. I have people in my life who are a big part of the reason I am able to be up here today, and I want to give them a part of the spotlight. I want to thank my parents, who have always believed in me. When I started middle school, something shifted in the way my parents participated in my education. They put trust in me to monitor my own grades in school life. There was less direct pressure from them, At this time, I already had the self-discipline to work hard on my schoolwork. But all of that was because of them. They always prioritized my education, and I will be forever grateful for their sacrifices and support. I don't know where they are, though. Mama? Papa? 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 Gracias por todo lo que me han dado en la vida. Yo soy mucho. Another person who has always believed in me is Mr. Washington. Wash is like family to me and so many others here. Whenever I doubted myself, he was always there to reassure me. He supported me in everything and constantly reminded me that I had the potential to succeed. He's amazing, and I will miss him dearly, even though I will see him tomorrow or next week. And every other day, because I'm always available. And lastly, I want to thank these next people for making my high school experience fun and memorable. Thank you, Ms. Kim, for always encouraging me, see Kim, to keep going, and for feeding me every Wednesday, along with your son, Melissa. Thank you. And to Mr. Worthline for inspiring and encouraging me. Oh yeah, Raul, I heard you. Thank you. Even though you raised your prices due to inflation. And now for my friends. Thank you to Yuritsa and Melissa for being with me all these years and dealing with my weird, odd behavior during class. That was very distracting, and you powered through it, and I'm proud of you. To Brian, for always staying by my side, as well as Ben, for always staying by my side. I met you guys later on in my high school career, but you were always there for me when I needed you. Thank you. Okay. To Kristen, who moved away junior year, but she always listened to my hardships and was always there. And also, she drove all the way here from San Diego. And to Ashley Chan for being the best coworker ever. My second piece of advice is to not label yourself and to keep an open mind about people. We live in a time where you're expected to label yourself, and that is the only way you are known. We're expected to label our sexuality, our positions, what groups we're a part of. But the truth is, a label is only the surface of a person's personality or being. And I know that if I would have kept the safeguarded mindset, I would not have been able to meet so many new, amazing people. Especially as we enter this new phase of our lives and a new beginning filled with new people with different backgrounds and life experiences. No matter if you're going to college or entering the workforce, we all have to open up and meet new people in these spaces. Life is all about creating human connections and networking, so don't inhibit yourself from meeting new people. My third and last piece of advice is the most important. It's to focus and prioritize yourself. Now, you may think that sounds a bit selfish and self-absorbed, but you cannot help anyone else if you don't help yourself first. By prioritizing yourself, I don't just mean putting others on the back burner. I mean, don't mess around, don't go to parties and stuff when you should be working or doing something for class. Help your future self. You will be so thankful when you finished everything instead of overworking yourself. You should be open to receiving help and help others around you. Be that person. This piece of advice is so important because it's something that everyone tells me, but somehow I never listen. In a way, this is also a reminder for myself because even though I call myself the master procrastinator, I was definitely not happy doing all that last minute work this semester. And okay, to wrap it up, because it's getting long, I would like to finish with a quote that provided me comfort and gave me motivation in these last 4 years. It's from a song, and if you want the artist's name, hit me up after. Dream. You will fully bloom after all the hardships. Dream. The beginning may be humble, but the future will be prosperous. Dream. Thank you.
Okay, now the second group of students I will name have earned a cumulative GPA of 3.0 to 3.59 as a high school student and will have a silver seal affixed to the high school diploma as well as being distinguished with an honor cord, with a silver honor cord. Honored students with silver cords, please stand. Congratulations. I am happy to now present to you the salutatorian for the graduating class of 2023. Yason Gomez is a graduating senior with the second highest GPA of 4.10. He will attend University of Southern California in the fall and will present our salutatory address.
To be here in front of all of you guys, but I'm gonna start. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud parents, and the remarkable class of, what are my class of AP Calc? Here you go. integral from b to a f of x dx equal. Where is AP class? Oh my god. 2023, there you go. Alright, this is for Miss Kim C. Alright, before I start, I want to thank God. My two brothers, Darwin and Alex, who supported me during these 4 years of high school, the days I fell alone, the days I did bad things, and the days I did good things. And only one is here today. My sister-in-law, who couldn't be here today, but she supported me a lot in those hard days. My uncle and auntie, who are here with me, my friends, and especially Jailene, who is graduating with me too. También quiero agradecer especialmente a mis padres que me están viendo desde Guatemala. Quiero decirles que a pesar de la distancia, a pesar de los momentos de que no estuve conmigo, sé que se sienten orgullosos de mí. Y seguiré en el mismo camino que ellos me enseñaron, el camino de respetar a los demás. El camino de respetar a los grandes, y estoy orgulloso de ser un Gómez, estoy orgulloso de ser hijo de Gilberto y Mayra Gómez. También quiero agradecer a mis hermanos que están allá, tengo dos hermanos, los quiero mucho, los aprecio y un fuerte abrazo. Ok, now, let's get it started. I came to this country 4 years ago. 5 classes started before the pandemic hit us and before becoming where I am now, a Trojan. Sorry, friends. Sorry, UCLA. That's right. My story starts when I had a choice to come here, and the question that I had was, what I will go to a country that I don't know and leave behind the most two important people that I love, which are my parents. But I came here to follow my dream, to study and demonstrate the world what I'm capable of. I have known many people who said that to me before, chasing the American dream. But I'm not just talking about it, but I'm doing it. Adapted to a new culture, I did it. I learned a new language, I did it. I experienced discrimination for my pronunciation, I did it. I made new friends, I'm proud of them. I did it. I learned new concept of history, for which many of you guys is boring. I did it. I wrote essays, which was a pain in the ass. It was a pain in the ass, but I did it. I applied to universities, I got in, I did it. I went through many challenges, but now that I know that I can break down into smaller pieces to follow my dreams and discover who I really am. When the road gets tough, remind yourself of your purpose. Picture the end goal and hold onto that vision. Test your resilience and make you stronger. Do not be afraid to stumble or fall, for it is in those moments that you learn valuable lessons and grow as an individual. Failure is not a destination. The countless hours of studying, the sleepless nights, the laughter, tears, and anger have led us to this moment of celebration, gathering us and seeing our effort as a milestone in our lives. So my friends, I implore you to believe in yourself, embrace your potential, for it is vast and infinity. You can do it. Let those words echo in your mind and guide your actions. The world is waiting for you to show who you really are, and I'm standing before you. I did it, we did it. Thank you. At this time, I would like to show a short clip to reflect on our time at Bernstein.
At this time, I would like to introduce one of our senior class teachers, Mr. Breimer.
What's up, seniors? Y'all are gonna miss that, right? Whoa. Too much gym time, right? Right, Carlos? Good evening. Thank you to the administration for letting me say a few words to the class of 2023. Let me first start by welcoming the graduating class, their family and friends. As I began thinking about what I wanted to say to this class, I was reminded of the very famous Greek philosopher, Socrates. Uh-oh, world history, y'all. Not good. Socrates was very intelligent, but gave very long speeches. And his friends killed him. Since I'm no Socrates, nor want to end up like him, I'm going to be very brief and to the point. 4 years have flown by really fast. It was like you started high school as freshmen, and then bam, COVID. You finish your freshman year online through Zoom, followed by most of your sophomore year. Now, I will say this, y'all, I really do admire this class. You had to endure something no other group of students in the history of this country had to endure. Over a full year of Zoom class. And us teachers had to endure. Over a full year of teaching to blank screens. Camera wasn't working, blah, blah, blah. I had to go to the bathroom, blah, 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 whatever. Okay. I believe it. So many of you have had the privilege to know over 2 years. It feels like yesterday when we arrived back on campus in person and you demanded passing grades for showing up. Then came the fall of 2022. You all showed up for your senior year with full backpacks and Starbucks lattes and breakfast sandwiches. Not to mention names, Carla, Melanie, Brian, right? By the way, on a side note, the Starbucks CEO and shareholders would like to thank you for their unprecedented profits this past year. But getting to know the senior class has been a real privilege. We've had some great times this past year. And all jokes aside, there is some real talent in this senior class. Victor, the graphic designer. Gavin, the voice. It's already been said, but Jason Gomez, you are an inspiration to many, including myself. Awesome work, young man. Pedro Diaz, the gym rat. Daniel Dubon, the musician. Jonathan Jimenez, the do-it-all, does everything. Manny Sayo, the fashionista. NIE, the athlete. Softball Division III champions, Mr. Finch. Juan de la Cruz, also known as QB1. Sam and Ashley, thank you for being my language interpreters. You are awesome. You guys are the best. Emily, the quiet academic. You're out there somewhere, Emily. Oh, there she is. Okay. Jaylene Mendoza. Where are you at, Jaylene? Jaylene, you might not know this reference, but there was a show back in the 80s called Doogie Howser. You are the Doogie Howser of this group because you're graduating early. Anthony, where are you at, Anthony? Where's my sports hater at? Anthony. Oh, there he is. Anthony the sports hater. Ashley Chan. Also another do-it-all for Bernstein, videographer, takes pictures, she does it all. The list goes on. Oh, and I cannot forget, last but not least, Glenda Escobar. Where are you at, Glenda? Now, the funny thing about Glenda is this. Glenda was willing to help me during class on anything, but I realized it was just to get out of my class. She didn't want to be in class, so she's like, oh, mister, I'll help you. So one thing I've learned with working with high school students for 18 years is that you don't always know what you want to do when you graduate. Most times, let's be honest, you guys have no idea. You're like, oh, I'll go to college, you know, I might get a job after high school. But I want to leave you with some advice by Steve Jobs, who's the former CEO of Apple. You guys have iPhones, right? Think Mr. Jobs? Okay. Steve Jobs said to graduates, you have to find what you love. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking, y'all. Good luck to all the graduates. Thank you, guys.
Now we would like to recognize our students who participated in the Paramount Mentoring Program. Through the many interactions with their mentors, they gain invaluable experiences that will guide them on their path to success. We would like to thank our students for their commitment to this program and also thank the Paramount mentors for their time, guidance, and dedication to our students. Paramount mentees and mentors, please stand. You can be seated. Okay, at this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Andrew Kasich, our assistant principal.
Thank you. This was a little bit of a tearjerker here, huh? We're gonna liven this thing up a little bit. First and foremost, before we get started, seniors, we have some people to thank. Okay, there are a lot of people out there who have helped get you to this spot right here and right now. Okay, so let's take a look at that. So to our front office staff, Miss Julie, Miss Michelle. My campus aides, proud of you over there. To my B&G staff, to our cafeteria workers, to my plant manager, Mr. Escobar, to the entire Bernstein staff, to the entire Bernstein faculty, all these people over here. My fellow administrators, Mr. Ramirez, Ms. Martinez, and to the best COSA in LAUSD, Dr. Brandy. Seniors, please give them a round of applause. And one last group of people we must thank to our entire Bernstein community and all our parents. Seniors, again, clap it up. So about a week ago, right before grad night, that was a long day. My daughter came up to me, she's 8, and she says, Dad, I think for your graduation speech, you should talk about what you've learned. Because, you know, you were a teacher, and teachers are really good at learning things. And I, of course, I stepped back and I said, man, I put this child on earth. Look at this brilliant child right here. And then she said, Dad, I want you to wear your blue suit for graduation because you look really handsome. And of course, I stepped back and I said, that's right. I put this child on earth right here. Man, she's smart. And then in the very next sentence, she said, oh, Dad, by the way, if you go to grad night, I need a plushie of Stitch and maybe some jewelry like a necklace. So, yeah, that was all a big setup for the big ask right there. The force is strong with that one. But in reality, I do want to talk a little bit about what I've learned this past year. Let's start with my staff. Now, I have learned that Ms. Carranza might be the best SAA that I've ever worked with. I mean, we're talking about a woman. Any problem that you have, it's just she gets behind the computer and there's like some keystrokes and the problem's gone. And you don't even know how it happened. Okay. Let's talk about Miss Julie. I have learned that while she might be the loudest human being I've worked with, she always has a smile on her face to greet everybody that walks through that door. And I've also learned that Miss Priscilla is just the queen of knowing exactly what you're going to need before you even know you need it. You just turn around, it's done. Okay. Let's talk a little bit about our faculty. Now, I have learned that Mr. Jones, this man right here, I'm not sure this man has ever taken a day off of work. He is always here. I have learned that Miss Amaya, she is a pretty damn good magna coordinator. I have learned that Dr. Littman has yet to figure out that we don't wear red at graduation. I love you, Dr. Littman. They're all holding their breath right now. I have learned that Mr. Millage. While he can't play basketball, he's pretty good at the drama thing. He is. I've also learned that Miss Taylor is a lot more like me than she wants to admit. And last, but certainly never least, never ever least, I have learned that Dr. Hart might be one of the finest human beings that has ever worked at Bernstein High School. Dr. Hart. Finally, let's talk about what I learned about this class right here. So, I learned that Sagun and Jomar, man, they are some of the nicest students I have ever known in my 20 years. I've also learned that Raul probably has a black bag full of hot Cheetos that he's going to sell after graduation. It's around here somewhere. Learned that, Oscar, you try real hard with the suit game. It's almost there, but it's not quite there, son. I've learned that Manny, I've learned that many his driver's license. Let's be honest. Okay, good. All right. I learned that Carlos Carrillo is very consistent, okay? I think he was the last senior to get to class every single day, but he was the last one to get on the bus to go home for grad night, too. Okay? I understand. I have learned that Harry Alfaro simply never has his sunglasses off. Okay. And finally, I have learned that Ruby and Mr. Worthwine might be the same person because I never see them together, but they are all about peace, love, and tranquility. Finally, let's talk about this school. I have learned that Local Region West is the best local region in the district, and you can tell Local Region South, and Mr. Spicer, I said that. Don't tell him I said that. I have learned that Bernstein High School is the best high school in the city. And you can tell Hollywood I said that. And finally, I have learned that the class of 2023 has been absolutely outstanding. Before we end the show here, I have been told that there is a special video that has been made for you guys to watch, a very short one. So without further ado, let's put that video up and see where it takes us.
greatest time you've been for. I love Rush. I love everyone.
Seniors, it is time to get this show on the road. So to all the parents and to Mr. Ramirez, I present to you the graduating class of 2023 at Helen Bernstein High School. Graduates, please rise.
Ladies and gentlemen of Helen Bernstein High School, by the power vested in me by the state of California and the Los Angeles Unified School Board District Board of Education, I hereby accept the graduating class of 2023, and I certify that each one of these young men and women who sit before us, robed in cap and gown, have completed their high school graduation requirements and have earned their high school diplomas and all the rights and privileges afforded to high school graduates. Helen Bernstein High School Class of 2023, congratulations. Now let's get down to business. Yvette Aguilar.
Tiger Alas Cerritos. Samantha Lisbeth Alcántara. Harry Alfaro Maldonado. Según Alfred. Jacob Anthony Almora. Jacqueline Diana Amaya. Arturo Antonio González. Daphne Arriaga Blanco. José Mario Arriola. Priscilla Avalos. Aaron Padaguas.
When I read it, then go.
Ashley Campos. Alessandra Gabby Campos. Carlos Carrillo. Manny Sea.
When I read it,
Ashley Paola Chan. Milady Coreas Alvarado. Leslie Grace Coronado Cooks. Luisa Cruz Hernandez. Juan de la Cruz. Cristal Devora. Joey Diaz. Oh.
Frances Janelli Diaz. Pedro Diaz Maldonado. Ashley Dominguez. Gustavo Dubon. Jonathan Escobar. Gabriel Omar Escobar Ramírez. Juan Rumike. Erteza Khan. Luis Landaverde. Sofía Lara Diamil. Wilder Lemons. Leslie López Muñoz. Shirley Aleph Madid. Jorge Maldonado. Andrea Isabel Mancía Hernández. Adriana Ramírez. Jean-Pierre Martínez. Milka Julieta Martínez. Ryan Leonel Oriana. Jasmine Martinez Mendez. Christian Joel Mateo. Oscar Matute. Nayeli Guadalupe Masas Rios. Rosalinda Masas Rios. Luis Mejía. José Ronnie Mejía Acabal. Maynard Daniel Méndez López. Ruby Mendoza Ramírez. Jaylene Mendoza. Kelly Caroline Munoz Galan. Alexis Noriega Sánchez. Soraya Edith Ochoa Chavez. Carla Orellana Muñoz. Melissa Ortiz. Jomar Xavier Montalvo. Yair Ortiz. Ashley Michelle Oxlash Hernandez. Palma Centeno. Vincent Pascua. Ruth Elizabeth Perez Juan. Garcia. Neil Pontias. Jaylene Portillo Morales. Samuel Quiñones. Dina Yasmín Ramírez. Daniel Ramírez. Jasmine Vanessa Ramos. Stephanie Reyes Cepeda. Annette Rivera. Ashley Lucia Rivera Barca. Matthew Rodriguez. Marilyn Melissa Rodriguez de Leon. Areli Marcela Rodríguez Herrera. Helen Alina Rojas Torres. Mariana Michelle Romero Recinos. Miguel Rosas. Michelle Ruiz Mauricio. Raul Antonio Kelly and Ruiz Flores. Joseph Sagastume. Elizabeth Salgado Celaya. Edwin Salguero. Christian Sanchez Martinez. Juan Sakic. Emily Gabriela Suchita Alana. Mario Eduardo Suchita Alana. Carlos Soto Alvarado. Fátima Giselle Trejo Méndez. Francisco Vázquez Ortega. Mariana Vázquez Hernández. Julián Velázquez. Yuritza Vielma González. Ashley Villa. Mariela Villaseñor. Jalissa Nicole Ward. Karen Sofía Zamora Granados. Xochitl Abigail Zárate. Jose Celaya Zek. Fátima Urimari Zúriga. Shante Neal. Oh. Abigail Deanne Lamotte.
Graduates, please stand. Before we close off, I do want to do one more thank you to a special person who has given their heart here the last 6-7 years. Dr. Hart, can you stand one more time?
at this time, as a symbol of graduation status, you may move your tassels from the right side of your clap to the left side. Congratulations, graduates. And now, your teachers will lead you for the recessional. Parents, please remain in your seats until the recession is completed. Thank you.